I had a dream that we were in a worldwide pandemic and several people didn't understand the damage it could do. Then I realized it wasn't a dream.
No! Coronavirus spreads through droplets of saliva or mucus from an infected person. A droplet of saliva from a cough can be 0.1 to 900 microns in size. To put into perspective, we can't even see smaller than 30 to 40 microns. A single hair is 100 microns, and 900 microns is 1.8 times bigger than a single grain of table salt. Without the ability to see the virus, it appears harmless, which has caused many to think, it's nothing, I'm gonna go hang outside with my friends. Well, stop right there! Let's scale the situation up. If we take that droplet, scale it up by 60, we can get this tiny droplet to the size of a medium-sized egg. That droplet can get inside our system through our mouth, nose, and eyes. So, for example, if we take the average length of an eye, also scale it up by our scale factor 60, it would be 5 feet. And coincidentally, I'm 5 feet. I hope you see where this is going.
So if someone were to cough at you in the eye, it would look like this. And if there are two Laurens, they would add up to the scaled up length of an average mouth. That's even a bigger chance of that droplet getting inside your system.
By the way, one droplet doesn't come out in a single cough. Rather, 3,000 droplets do. That's 250 cartons of eggs. Not only that, potentially 200 million coronaviruses could be in that cough.
Lauren! Lauren!
What?
Lauren, it's me, the other Lauren. You know the one that you threw an egg at? Anyways, I have a question. If we take the average length of a virus, which is 0.3 microns, scaled up by 60, it would only be 18 microns. We wouldn't even be able to see it in the egg. It's under the viewing threshold. How can it be so dangerous?
Well, even though viruses are tiny, they can cause some great havoc, even causing our immune system to be the cause of our death. Let's start from that cough from earlier.
Once those droplets get inside, coronavirus travels through your throat, trachea, all the way to the inside of your lungs. Here inside are cells with ACE2 receptors. Coronavirus can attach itself with its protein spikes to a receptor and inject its genetic material. Coronavirus then duplicates itself as much as it can, using everything which kills that cell. Virus particles then travel to more cells, repeating the process. The dead cells start to release cytokine, signaling an inflammatory response. More cells than needed flood into attack. The immune system needs to regulate the number of immune cells, or they will go into overdrive. This is how a cytokine storm starts. Now, roughly three different outcomes can occur. Outcome one, your immune system regulates with little to no damage. Outcome two, the dead cells cannot regenerate due to permanent lung damage. You'll no longer fully breathe normally. Or outcome three, your lungs' own tissue and lining are killed and melted away. Bacteria can now infect the lungs because it's now weakened. The little sacs in our lungs, which we breathe with, called alveoli, start to fill with fluids. Pneumonia begins to be contracted. Bacteria then spreads. Your body starts to kill everything trying to desperately save you but can't.
I had a dream that we were in a worldwide pandemic, but after 3 minutes, several people understood the damage it could do. Now it's up to you to be part of the solution. I'm Lauren Pham, and I hope you have a lovely day. Thank you.